Okay, we will make a short flight for family and friends. This is a Boeing 737-800. We are now lined up on runway 34 of Juhu Airport. Our plans are to fly the runway heading and then take a turn to 270. This is 270. This is 090. This is 360. And this is 180. And then take a turn to 180. This is Mumbai International. We are the two cross runways here. We will be landing on runway 27. That is 270 magnetic. This is runway 27, and the reciprocal of that is runway 09, that is 90. So here we will take a turn 090. Parallel to this runway, and at somewhere at around 12 nautical miles, we will take a heading change to 310. Our objective is to intercept the center line of the runway using the instrument landing system, ILS, which will automatically turn the plane into the center line of the runway. The ILS will be tuned into the radio system of the aircraft. We'll see all that. Okay, now let us start flying. Okay, we are now in the cockpit or the flight deck of the Boeing 737-800. I'll move the engines so we are audible. We'll have a quick tour of the cockpit. Everything we can't cover in detail. The video will get lengthy, but we will cover essentials to explain this flight. This top part, what you see is called the master control panel, MCP. All flight parameters that control the plane are put in here. Other than in the flight management system, flight management computer, which you will see below. These are the autopilot engage buttons. You can see AP engage, and CMD stands for command. So both autopilots, both command buttons are actuated when you are on auto landing. Auto landing in the sense when you are zero, almost zero visibility. But for this flight in clear weather, I'll be using one command, one autopilot. This is the altitude window. You can see you can move like turning this wheel. This is the heading window. Again, you can change. This is the indicated airspeed, IAS, the speed of the plane. There are various speeds, but we will limit to IAS, indicated airspeed now, which is set now, let us say to 12. And this is the course, which is the runway course of runway 27 at Bombay, where we will be landing. This is the auto throttle button. This is a flight director button. This is the approach button. This is altitude halt. And this is the heading halt. This is the flap position. Now we have set the flap for 5 for takeoff. This is the brake position. Now set for takeoff, RTO. That is rejected takeoff. And for landing, you will be moving this brake to 2 or 3, depending on the runway condition. These are some auxiliaries. This is the landing gear. It's in green now. showing that it is down. These are the engine parameters: the speed of the engine, exhaust temperature, fuel flow. Here, these two are the main flight navigation instruments. This one is called PFD, primary function display. And this one is called navigation display by Airbus, and MFD, multifunction display by Boeing. Let's expand this. In PFD here, what you see as blue is the sky, and what you see brown is the earth. And this is the plane, shows the wing in level and in horizontal flight. This is the pitch angles, 5, 10, 15. And these are the bank or the roll angles, 30 and 60. This is the magnetic compass. This is speed tape. We have set the indicated airspeed 212. So this shows the set speed. This is altitude tape. We have set the altitude 2900. This is the altitude tape. We have set the altitude 2900. Let's see back here. This is the altitude. This is the speed. This is the vertical speed. This is the vertical clamping speed. This is the descending speed. When you are taking off, this needle will go up to about 1,000 feet per minute. And while descending, it will be down here. What you see in this window is the altitude above mean sea level. So this is the barometric altitude. And what you see here is the radio altitude. That is the altitude above ground level. So in other words, if you're flying in Hyderabad, let's say the runway is 1800 feet above mean sea level, this will be showing 1800, this will be showing zero. This is the set barometric pressure. In the MFD, what you see, this triangle is the plane, and this is the magnetic compass. So runway heading is 337 at Juhu, where we are now. So it shows 337 heading, magnetic. And so many other details are here, which we will cover some other time. This shows 20 nautical miles, this circle here. When you have a flight plan, let's say from Bombay to Heathrow, you can see the entire flight route here, each waypoint. We will look at this at a later time. Okay, now we looked at all this. There are many other details which we will discuss later. Now we will look at other things. This is the yoke as used by Boeing, and in Airbus, you have a side stick here. To look at this, we need to start simulator again. This tap, pitch down. All right, all left. You see this? Have the rudder pedals. Okay, now let us look at this flight management system which we referred earlier. And this is a flight management computer. This is called MCDU, Master Control Display Unit, where you plug in all your flight parameters, the flight plan, and nav log, nav 11.10.30, which is the Bombay ILS frequency, is tuned in here. 270 is the course for the ILS runway 27. So these are all plugged in into this system, FMS or flight management computer, which in turn controls the autopilot, auto throttle, flight director, or automatic operation of the plane. Now let us look at this part enlarged. These two are the throttles. What you see, this wheel is the stabilizer wheel. Now, if you remember the 737 MAX story of Jakarta, Ethiopia, and subsequent landing of all MAX 8, this is the stabilizer was the key issue. Anyway, on that sometime later. This is the flap lever, which controls the flaps and slats on the trailing edge and also the leading edge. This is how you move the flap position. It comes into the slot and it doesn't change. It doesn't get disengaged unless you move it. So this is the landing configuration, approximately 40 or 30. You must have seen when you land, the flaps are folded all the way down. So this is flap down, 40 fully down. For takeoff, it will be extended marginally, horizontally. And for this flight, I will be using flap 5. These are the fire suppression switches inside. This is engine 1 and 2, and this APU. APU is the engine behind, which gives power initially for the air conditioning, the instruments, and even for starting the first engine. Sometimes you have other ways to start the engine. This is the brake. Parking brake. So what you see here is called the tiller, which controls the nose wheel of the plane and used for the turning, large turning. This is the spoiler or the speed brake. You have seen on the top of the wing, there is a flap which is moving up. This is the radio stack. Now here it shows 110.30, which is the radio frequency of ILS runway 27 of Mumbai. Okay, now we will take a look at the overhead panel quickly. These are the starter buttons. Most of them are preset. So these are the lights, landing lights, strobe lights, so many lights. These are the fuel pumps. This is the air conditioning system, pressurization system. These are the electrical bus control, AC-DC. This is our familiar fasten seat belt. These are the hydraulic pump control, used hydraulic system used for many purposes, like actuating the controls, the engine operation, etc. Below here is the cockpit voice recorder, and above here is the flight data recorder. Both together are the black boxes used for investigation in case of a flight mishap. This is the inertial reference system display. Now from outside the plane, this is the radar. These are the flaps. The one on the top is the speed brake or the spoiler. These are the aileron, which is I had to put the SIM back on to show them actuated. What you're seeing is the aileron here, which is turning the plane left or right. These are the flaps, which we have discussed. This is the radar. And what you see here is elevator, which allows you to pitch up or pitch down. Let's look at, put the simulator back. Maybe you are not able to hear me, but let me just. Up, down, all right, all left, left, right, and up. Let us stop here. Now we will go back to the flight deck and take off the plane after setting everything finally.